5 dozen point 7. Hey y'all, artist poet girl here, also known as APG Jamie, and today we're taking part in an art hop primitive. That's hashtag art hop primitive, and I'm going to be making some clay beads. Now, to follow the art hop, be sure to click on the first link in the description box below to go to the next video in the hop, and you'll do that till you get back to me, and then you've seen all the videos. Now please be sure to like, kind comment, and share. If you're not already subscribed, please do so. We all appreciate it. We all appreciate y'all. So anyway, I decided what's more primitive to making your own clay beads. So that's what I thought I'd do. Now, you saw I put some gloves in a bottle on my hands. That's just a slight barrier cream, not a total barrier cream. Anyway, so I have my air dry clay. I rolled it out into a snake, which y'all saw, and I've just rolled the snake. Well, I cut it in half, and then I rolled it across a script stamp. That was to put texture in it. This is not for reading or any other purpose, just to put some texture in there, okay? And now I'm cutting them down so that they're more or less the same size. They're not all going to be exact because some part of my clay snake is bigger than the other part. Now we're going to smooth the ends there just a little bit because we'll sand them off to make them a little smoother later on after they dry. But for now, I'm just going to smooth them off and make them a more similar in size. Now we're going to make some round ones. Now if you're going to do these with this air dry clay, it is fairly breakable, okay, at least till you get it painted and sealed up. So I would say make about twice as many as you think you want. Seriously. So now we're going to make some round ones, and again I rolled out the little clay snake. And I'm cutting off little sections so I can make the round ones. And you just roll them in the palms of your hands. They come out oval, egg shape, oblongy, and then just kind of make it more round. Make it rounder. Okay? And it's time to put the holes in there. They've set up and dried out a little bit. And I've put just a tiniest bit of glycerin into that little lid of water. That's just to help keep the inside a little moisture while I make the holes. I'm taking a plastic canvas, you know, the old cross stitch on the plastic canvas needle, because they got big eyes on them and they're blunt tipped, and I'm pushing that through the bead. I'm not squeezing the bead very tightly because it is still wet. Well, it's damp. It's not wet. It's damp. And then you're going to see, I'm going to show a close-up where I'm wiggling the needle around in there to bore out the hole, make it a little bigger. Later on, we'll be putting toothpicks in there while I let them dry. I did speed the drying process in the oven. This is not a recommended thing by the manufacturer. It's just something I took upon myself to do. And there are the round ones, which I'm doing the same way. And I'm dipping my needle into the little, water thing there. Yeah. And I baked them for about 30 minutes. About 30 minutes. And I rotated them every 10 minutes. And they were baked at like 175. And I turned the oven off and left them in there till the oven cooled down. And I set them out in the studio and let them dry. Here I'm putting toothpicks in them because in my head... Okay, this is just in my head. This is not necessarily a recommended thing. This is just what I did, okay? In my head, the toothpick would help draw the moisture out from the inside there, which it did, and also would help keep them from cracking and breaking. But like I said, this air dry clay is very fragile and breakable you know, once it is dry like this, whether it naturally air dries or you speed it along in the oven, which is not recommended, so at your own risk. All right, people? So now we're going to sand the little ends off because some of them have, you know, just slightly misshapen, you know, and stuff like that. So I'm just going to use that fingernail file, you know, one of the foamy ones, and sanding it down just a little bit. I'm not making these really smooth because this is a primitive project, all right? And there are the longer bead, not the round one. The first one was the round one. So anyway, as you can see, my holes are pretty nice. I'm really happy with that. Now, to get the dust off, I'm going to use a damp, baby wipe. And I'm just very briefly running out that over there. And now I'm ready for painting because my beads are good and dry. All right. They ended up sitting out in the studio over the weekend. It's on air conditioning and it's summertime when I made these. So, yeah, they dried pretty good. And I'm using a toothpick. I've got my bead stuck onto the toothpick and I'm just painting it. I took magenta. And I think it was magenta. The description box below is a list of ingredients, all right, as along with the links to the other videos in the video hop. So anyway, I'm holding it with a toothpick while I'm painting it. Oh, I was going to tell you what I mixed. I mixed magenta with bronze, copper. Oh, I don't remember. So anyway, it was a regular color paint, and then I mixed a metallic paint with it, and yeah, you can see I'm just painted. It's just a whole lot of the same thing, and those are paper clips that I have pulled apart and shaped up, and I'm hanging them off to the side, which in a little bit you will see a photo of how I'm hanging those. And we can thank Al John for that, which there'll be a link to her in the upper right hand corner and in the description box below, because she's the one that showed me, or you know, it was her video that I saw how to make the little hangers for the beads while you're letting them dry. Okay, so now we're antiquing, and this is burnt umber. Pretty sure that's what it was. List of ingredients in the description box below. Okay, so I did that with the round ones. I did it with the longer ones that have the stamping on them. Remember, they're you know, have the texture on them. So I found what worked best for me was to put this glaze on three of them. Go back to the first one, brush it off with a damp baby wipe. That is not a wet baby wipe, just a damp one. And you can see the difference between the one that has the antiquing and the one that does not. Now, because these are damp, I am putting it back on the paperclip hanger and setting them aside over there on my little bottle, which there'll be a picture coming up here momentarily. And I did that with all the longer beads. The round ones I did not wipe off. I just left the thin end ticking on there. Now we're sealing them up, and I'm using triple thick. And I have taken my triple thick and smooshed it onto my little palette there and mixed in just a little bit of water, just a little bit of water, to make it just a little easier to smear on the beads. And did two coats of paint plus the antiquing and two coats of the triple thick. Because like I said, these beads can be fairly fragile. I do have an ultimate project for these beads, and there'll be two more videos to back this one up before, you know, and you'll see the final project in the third video. I'm happy with it because it's done, and I'm happy with it. And here is what the beads, the round ones, look like without the clear triple thick on there and with the triple thick on there. So you can get an idea of what they look like. So anyway, for this video hop, this art hop primitive, be sure to search for that hashtag and follow the links in the description box below to go to the next video in the hop. And when you get back to me, you've made the complete rounds. So thanks so much for watching. I appreciate each and every one of you liking, kind commenting, and sharing. Disclaimer screen. Thanks for watching, and happy arting, y'all.